For many people, the first experience of marine environment is amazement at the bewildering variety of life in the ocean. Sea anemones and corals, sea stars and sea urchins, octopuses, squids, sharks, whales are just a few marine creatures that we never encounter. It is difficult for those interested in marine life to go underwater and capture images. Shore photography by automated underwater robot is a boost to these people to study marine life from the land. This aqua robot is also helpful to study aquatic environment like light, temperature, humidity, pressure of water. This data is very helpful for marine biologists.
BeagleBone Black is a prototyping development board designed for hobbyists and users like us. Talking about the external connector, the board has 2x46 GPIO ports, which includes 7 ADC pins, 5 serial ports, 4 PWM ports, 67 digital ports. Furthermore, it has got a JTAG header, 1 USB host port, 1 client port, 1 HDMI port, 10 RJ45 Ethernet port. The board uses the given client USB port or the RJ45 Ethernet port as an option for SSH connection. Now talking about the embedded integrated circuit, it runs on 1 GHz TI Sitara AM3358 Cortex-8 ARM processor, which is the heart of the board. Secondly, it has a 2GB 8-bit eMMC flash storage and micro SD card slot. Thirdly, it comes with a 512 MB SD RAM, which supports 1080 video encoding and decoding and a HDMI framer. This is the HD camera cape designed by Aptima Imaging. The cape provides high resolution camera photo capturing function to a BeagleBone Black platform. The cape comes with an adjustable lens and a CMOS sensor of an expansion board, which supports image capturing up to 1280 into 960 resolution at 10 fps. Further interesting features include the 720p HD video capturing at 30 fps, superior low light performance at ultra low power, and it supports Linux, Angstrom and Android operating system. These are two pairs of IR transmitter and receiver, which we shall be using as an obstacle detector. The receiver shall be giving us analog values, which when crosses any threshold value, indicates any obstacle hitting the robot's body. This is LM35 temperature sensor, which will provide us the temperature of water body. This is light dependent resistor, which when exposed to light varies the resistance, hence it will provide the intensity changes in the water body. This is TP-Link's TL-MR3020 network adapter, which supports 3 network configuration, that is as an access point, as a repeater and as an WISP adapter. We shall be configured this adapter as a repeater that shall provide us repeated and strengthened network signals through a LAN cable, since network are unable to reach the rover in the water body. One end of LAN cable is connected to the aqua board and the other is connected to the router. The router is configured as a repeater that will be connecting dongle's network to the aqua board. The network of dongle is connected to the PC. By this connection, there is an interconnection between aqua board, TP-Link, dongle and PC.
Pyrus is the name of the dongle. Aqua board is connected to this network wirelessly. 192.168.1.80 is the IP address of BeagleBone Black's network. This is the reply by pinging BeagleBone Black's network. PuTTY is used to SSH in BeagleBone Black. By default, root is the username of BeagleBone Black. Ultra VNC viewer will display the screen of the aqua board. The IP address of BeagleBone Black is written in Ultra VNC Viewer. In the terminal window, code for aqua board is executed. Now by writing IP address of AquaBot in web browser, the web page to control AquaBot is displayed. This is the web page to control the AquaBot. There are virtual switches to control the AquaBot. By toggling the switches, the state of motors connected to AquaBot is changed. The readings from sensors are displayed in the ADC readings column. IR sensors are used to detect obstacles. LDR sensors are used to detect intensity of light. Temperature sensors are used to get the temperature of water. This is the image from the camera.
This is a demonstration of how AquaBot will work underwater. Our AquaBot. Now we are going to test this in a swimming pool. As you can see, there are sensors connected to this. This is LDR sensor. This will detect the intensity of it. This is IR sensor. As you can see that AquaBot is not connected with the lifeboat. The teammate sitting over there will control the movements of AquaBot. Now we are going to test our AquaBot in this dirty lake.